हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम आमिर खान, करेंटली परसुइंग बीएलएलबी फ्रॉम विवेकानंद कॉलेज ऑफ लॉ अलीगढ़। करेंटली आई एम आल्सो इंटर्नेट लेक्सिस एंड कंपनी लॉ फर्म। सो माय प्रेजेंटेशन टॉपिक इज हिस्ट्री एंड यूज ऑफ लीगल मैगजीन इन लॉ। लीगल मैगजीन एंड टर्म्स आर एन एस्टेब्लिश्ड प्रिंसिपल और प्रीपोजिशन ऑफ लॉ और लीगल पॉलिसी, यूजली स्टार्टेड इन लैटिन फॉर्म। दीज आर यूज ऑन अ रेगुलर बेसिस इन द लीगल डोमेन ड्यू टू देयर प्रिसाइज एंड एक्यूरेट मीनिंग, स्पेशली बाय द जजेस। In order to ensure a tactile basis in the judgments, they serve as a legal jargon due to their confined application and understanding among the individual of the legal system. Maxims and legal terms usually do not have the dogmatic authority of statutes, neither they are normally considered as law except to their application in the adjudicated matters to a certain extent, and in some cases are incorporated by the legislature while framing laws. Origin of the most of the Latin maxims can be traced in the European states of medieval era that used Latin as their legal language. With the expansion of commerce and industry during the 16th and 17th century, English courts were faced with novel cases for which the judges felt the need for broad authoritative principles in order to support their judgment, because the rules of the medieval common law proved of Latin or no significance while deciding those cases. The problems of judges and the attitude of early English philosophers like Thomas Hobbes, who in his book Doctor and Student stated that legal maxims are of the same strength as that of acts and statutes, and Francis Bacon, who in the preface to his book Collection of Maxims stated that maxims would be used in deciding doubts and help soundness of judgment, but further in gracing argument, in correcting unprofitable subtlety and reducing the same to a more sound substantial sense of law, in reclaiming vulgar errors, and generally in the amendment in some measures of the very nature and a complexion of the whole law led to evolution of legal maxims. Indian courts, such collection of legal terms and maxims followed by explanatory comments and reference to the illustrative cases continued to appear during the next three centuries in England and United States, and even the Indian legal system, being subject to British rule for centuries, has extensively opted the legal terms and maxims as a part of the legal jargon. Indian courts witness and interpret large number of legal maxims and terms. Some of them are as follows: Actio personalis moritur cum persona. This maxim means that a personal right of action dies with person. According to it, a person cannot opt for a legal recourse once he is dead. However, the Supreme Court of India has limited its scope to certain actions, like action for damages for defamation, action for assault, and action for other personal injuries not causing the death of the party. Supreme Court in Girja Nandini Devi and others versus Bijendra Narayan Chaudhary held that an action for account is not an action for damages ex delicto and does not fall within the enumerated classes. Nemo debet esse in propria sua causa. This maxim means that no one ought to be judged in its own cause. It's human tendency to lean towards personal benefit whenever possible, hence a person presiding over a matter that involves his personal interest will definitely pass an order to avoid such happenings, and to ensure that justice is rendered in real sense, it is necessary to ensure the implementation of this maxim in due course of legal proceedings in order to ensure justice of the victim. Other than legal maxims, there are plenty of legal terms that we witness in legal jargon, like corpus juris, compendium of law, guardian ad litem, a legal guardian appointed by the court during the course of a litigation to protect the interest of infant or mentally incompetent person involved in litigation, amicus curiae, friend of the court. They are in amicus curiae, friend of the court, contract and agreement between two parties that are enforceable or otherwise recognizable at law, judicial concerning the process of judging, and countless others. From the above discussion, we can conclude that legal terms and maxims are of higher importance among the people of legal arena, because it not only helps the judges to support their, but also it makes the judicial process a bit more conductive and short due to their precise nature. So with time, they have evolved as an indispensable part of the judicial system and is also getting common among the folks. So this is all about the history and use of legal maxims. and if you please like this video and share subscribe the channel of Lexis and Company Law Firm Chennai. So thank you and have a nice day.